Hello, everybody. It's Dr. Zeno with 15 Minute Fuel. We're just in 15 minutes a day. We're going to fuel your mind, your body, and your future. Just for the announcements, as usual, hope you guys enjoyed episode 36 that came out yesterday. Sweet episode. Thank you so much for commenting and liking. And then today, also, if you are listening to this on podcast and you would like to listen to that to catch up, make sure you go to SoundCloud, Stitcher, and iTunes. We're on there. Also on iTunes or all those areas, please rate it because our ratings get us up, of course, and gets us seen in front of more people to share this message. It's 100% no cost to you and those people out there. So thank you so much for doing that. Also, join our other social media, our Snapchat, our Instagram, our Twitter, and the Dr. Zeno fan page as well. Thank you so much for those. Remember, don't forget the IamHero.com site /freebie. You will actually be able to get into the 1 month to win. That's the mini course I have for you guys. Again, at no cost whatsoever. And it's making winning a habit. So a habit isn't an act. It's a constant thing. To make something a habit, it's an everyday thing. So we want to make sure winning becomes part of your life. It builds your confidence and your value. So thank you guys for doing so much of that, getting your cool swag and shirts. Some of you guys commented. I put a post on Instagram today and Facebook in my unicorn shirt, and you guys really enjoyed that. So thank you so much. And it was about balance. And kind of that's what I'm going to talk about today. I'll start off with the shirt said. The shirt says, I have a unicorn. It eats fairy dust and craps gold, and its name is Balance. Basically, it's saying it's a myth. It's a myth. Balance is a myth. It's an industrialized society thing to keep people mediocre. You can be great in all the areas. I can be a great husband, an amazing father, a great doctor. I could take care of my body when I want to. You work at it. So instead of just saying I'll save some time for this and some time for that and balance my life, with the problem with the whole balance in life thing, everybody feels that they're out of balance because they're comparing themselves to somebody else. It's not about balance, it's about values. You know, you know your values are things you want. You become great at what you want. I see people line up in Starbucks for 20 minutes to pay very, very expensive prices, over $2,000 a year in Starbucks junk, because they want to. It's valuable to them. It increases their status. That's how they feel. All right, so it's not about, I mean, if you wanted balance, then don't go there. Spend more time at home. So it's not about balance, it's about values, all right? So I'm actually creating a mini course. I'm in the process. Right after this, I'm going to eat and shoot this mini course. And a lot of you want to know about my time management or how do I find the time to do everything I do. And I'm like, is time management the right? I was trying to write the title. Is it time management? Is it productivity? And I realized it's time efficiency. That's the new opportunity I'm talking about here. It's not time management. It's time efficiency. Making your time valuable. And I'm going to go over, I have 20 of them. So we'll actually go through all 20, not today, of course. Let me go through part 1 through 4, all right? So the number one thing I'm going to talk about with time efficiency is I want you to start thinking in seconds, not minutes and hours and days. And the best way I could describe it is in my office. So when I started growing and we had, you know, there was having one of the largest chiropractic clinics in the world, you only have so much, you are only able to see so many patients in an hour, right? That's usually the limiting belief. You know, when someone says, how do you see 500 a day? Or how did you see 2,600 people per week? By yourself, that's impossible. I only see 50 or 100. And so what it was is because I started to think in seconds. Because what happens when I was in the moment, when I was going through the pain of, because see, when something new happens, it creates a different problem, right? So the good news was more new patients are coming in. Their lives are being changed. But it creates a new problem. The new problem is, what am I going to do with all these new patients? Where are they going to park, right? New problems with good things. So it's a good problem to have. So when new patients were coming, I'm like, how can I deliver the same value? What is the value they need in more efficient time? So I was forced to not think in minutes that I adjust someone in so many minutes. I had to start thinking in seconds. And when I started thinking in seconds, my entire life expanded. Then I realized, well, when I walk around that table, that takes 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 seconds. I see 2,000 patients a week times 3 seconds. What's that? 6,000 seconds, which is like hours, right? For me walking around the table. So I said, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to stay on one side of the table. Boom, done. All these little things I saw where I was wasting 1 or 2 seconds, because in life, on a periodic basis, whatever you're doing, if you find it might only be 1 or 2 seconds, but when it's compounded by 1,000 or 2,000, I really figured out in my life that I was wasting days. So when I actually changed the way I adjusted, or I didn't walk around the table, or change the pattern I adjusted, like I went in a fluid motion, I decreased my steps in between the tables, and I figured out the seconds. I figured out I was saving like a combination of 5 to 6 hours a week by just that one little thing or a couple things I did. So that 5 or 6 hours a week, now when I adjusted all those people, it felt like I felt we were slow, because I became time efficient. I started thinking in seconds. My morning routine, I think in seconds, all right? So when you bring your day down to seconds, number one, it expands the day. You have all the time in the world. It's so funny, like when the camera team is here, they'll be like, Dr. Z, I'm like, what time is it? They'll be like, oh, it's 1:58. Like, I have 2 minutes, right, to do this. And I'm like, oh man, we got 120 seconds. Like to me, that's forever. And it really brings you in the present time. So when you start looking in the micro at the seconds and just your daily things, just think of the things you do at work. Think to yourself, how can I save a second but still raise the quality? That's the two things I justify. So for me, I don't have to walk around the table. I could deliver the adjustment this way, same quality, more time efficient. I'm just using a personal story like that. Or working out. Today I worked out, right? So I train arms. You can see, look at those. They're still pumped. All right, so what I did is, instead of doing a set of biceps and waiting for a minute, and then doing a set of triceps and waiting for a minute, I do a set of biceps, put it down, set of triceps, done, set of biceps. So I supersetted them, still got the same workout, the same number of sets in shorter time, same work, actually more effective, all right? And then I was able to get home. So it becomes, I think in seconds, it becomes time efficient. So start, and just, you could just think of all the cool things you could do in your life. So go through your life and see, well, wow, you know, for instance, Facebook, a lot of you guys, and I've seen it, you know, a lot of times, a lot of you guys have your notifications on, right? You know, so meaning that like your phone will be in your pocket and it buzzes every time someone on Instagram likes something or Facebook likes something. So every time that thing buzzes, what happens, it's almost like you got a present, right? So you want to see what that is, right? So you do that 250 times a day, that's 250 seconds, all right? So what is that? That's 4 minutes for the day that you did this. Probably more than 4 minutes. It's because then you, when you look at it, you open it, you do this. So let's say you probably waste an hour a day doing that, and then that's like, you know, in 24 days, you lost one full a day doing this, okay? So what you do is turn your notifications off. Because then what I do to be efficient, like when I hit the thing on Facebook, the app, it comes up, and then I see all your messages and stuff, and I just deal with your messages. I don't even go on the feed. I comment, I delete, and then boom, I'm done. Or Instagram, I hit it, I'll see there's 87 things. I chunk it, versus, because I know if I kept on doing this, right? It, number one, it breaks your focus, number one. So you know when you break your focus, you don't get back on focus. It could take you 20 minutes to get back. So it's these little things that I think about. I'm not being neurotic. I think in seconds. So if I could save seconds, it totally changed your life. And then when someone says you don't have the time, when you start to think in seconds, you have so much time. It's amazing. That's number one. Number two, I want you to wake up earlier, right? We can't make more time, right? So that's why it's time efficiency. But if you wake up a little bit earlier, you created a little bit more time. I know on Sundays I might sleep till 8:30, and that's not late, right? It's 8:30. But when I usually get at 4:30, I wake up, and at 8:30, it feels like I woke up the same, but I realized that was 4 hours that I didn't lose, but 4 hours that could have been utilized for something. For me on Sunday, I use those 4 hours to sleep, right? So that's my choice. But imagine, you know, if you did that, you know, for 6 weeks in a row, and I missed those 4 hours, if I woke up at 4:30 and got those 4 hours back, or chose to, in 6 weeks, that would be one full day of uninterrupted total productivity, right? So wake up earlier. And then number three, the opposite, stay up a little bit later, just a little bit later. Because remember, we talk about, you're in your 9-to-5 job, or you're in your job, you're in that thing that makes you a living, you're in that thing that gives you the paycheck. But we also need during the day to do the thing that creates our life, the thing that we were called to do. So for those of you that love speaking, writing, video, singing, whatever that loving thing that you do, if it's a hobby, we want to make sure you have that hobby every single day. So that might be the 9 to 5. If you're building a business on the side that you love to do, then do that after work, right? So you're making a living here and you're creating a future here. So it could be as little as an extra half hour of uninterrupted time. So if you have kids go to bed. I can't speak for myself. My kids actually always stay up after I do. I beat them to bed every single day. But just for you, if the kids are in bed, you get an extra half hour to do whatever that thing you're working on. So imagine if you worked a half hour a day on what you love to do. At the end of the week, it's three. You know what's that? It's an extra 3.5 hours that you actually apply to something you love to do. So look, you could build a website, you could build a webinar. Look at all the things you could do with 3.5 hours of uninterrupted time. So wake up a little bit earlier, stay up a little bit later. No big deal. All right, a time efficiency. And then 4, schedule your day, your week, your month, and your year. Jim Rohn said it best. He says, finish your day before you start it. Something like that. Meaning that tomorrow, have your day planned out. You know, this is what I'm going to do during the day. It's planned out. So finish your day before you start it. And then get used to that. Then finish your week before you start it. Finish your month before you start it. So actually have a plan the best you can. And what that is, when you have a plan, you have these, you're like on a mission. So you wake up with that mission driven, let's get this stuff done. And when you have a plan, those little things you get done is a feeling of accomplishment and winning. And that makes you feel great. And it's nice to see that you check the things off and that's on that daily checklist where you win. And this is where you can get all those things in through the week. So when you think in seconds and you make your life efficiency, you wake up a little bit earlier, you stay up a little bit later, and that's the time to get the things that you love to do done where you say you don't have the time. And then you schedule your day, your week, your month, and your year. That's a fun thing to do. You sit down with your spouse or yourself, anybody. You don't have to be married for this. And you get a Google Calendar and it's blank and you schedule your vacations or the things you're going to do for fun, your vacations with the family, or if you're married, the family and the long weekends. Then you put down, what are you doing for New Year's and Christmas and your birthday? Put all that stuff in. That's solid. And then you put in your date nights or the weekly things you'd love to do for yourself. You got to make an appointment for yourself. Put an appointment for your workouts. Put an appointment when you cook. And then put the work schedule in there. So what happens is you run your calendar. The calendar doesn't run you. So hopefully you enjoyed the first 4 tips in time efficiency. I'm trademarking that term, time efficiency. And hit the share button. Love it, like it, and you'll do it. So I got 1 through 4 done, and we will continue to go through all the way to 20. If you have any questions or comments, please comment. Even if it's not live, I will answer you, of course. And once again, thank you so much. Episode 36 was great. Thank you for going to I Am Hero. So the iamhero.com/freebie or freebies, they're holding my free mini courses. So you guys have the winning mini course. I'm doing a mini course here on time efficiency. I'm going to film one today on I Am Value, boosting the value in your life. Boosting the value of your product, services, ideas, and life. Because a lot of times, for those of you who have to sell something, we're always selling, right? Whether it's ourselves or people, you know, we want to increase your value and worth to the marketplace so you know you feel good and you have a good value for yourself. So those, you'll see those come out. But we did 1 through 4. Make sure you tune in. Make sure you like everything. Go to the store. Get your cool shirts. We have a couple new shirts or ideas coming out. Hope you enjoy them, and please share this with other people, because that's the way we change the world. Have an amazing, blessed Saturday, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Tomorrow's Sunday, so you'll see Justice Zeno on tomorrow's episode. Have a blessed weekend. God bless.